What's up, MetaNerdz? This video is all about the Raven's Claw, a ship used by Kyle Katarn after the Moldy Crow was damaged. Classified as a light courier, it wasn't technically a starfighter, nor was it intended to be used like a freighter, but as you will see, it is a very unique ship that doesn't really fit easily into any category. Its manufacturer is unknown, but a lot of its parts make people believe that it was a custom ship built using a majority of Corellian Engineering Corporation parts. The hull is similar to the HWK-290, while these large engines look a lot like those found on a pod racer, or perhaps those used in Nubia Star Drive creations. Its cost is unknown, and honestly it's very difficult to make an estimate, since it very well may be a custom build, but here are the prices of vehicles from which it may be using parts. Its top speed is also unknown, but it would likely be between 1,000 and 1,200 kilometers per hour, a range from the HWK-290 up to the TIE Fighter. The armament is where you may find the most notable improvements upon Katarn's previous ship, the Moldy Crow, since it has a pair of laser cannons, but now two proton torpedo launchers. At 20 meters or 66 feet long, it was two Wookiees shorter than the X-Wing, and an A-Wing shorter than the HWK-290. Being 13.57 meters, or 44.5 feet across, it was three Jawas wider than the X-Wing, or just around half the width of the Millennium Falcon. And at 4.1 meters, or 13 feet tall, it was less than half the length of an AT-ST, or a TIE Fighter, while being a porg taller than the ARC-170. The cargo capacity was unknown, but it couldn't have been much, and like the Moldy Crow, it only required a crew of two, a pilot, and co-pilot. These roles were filled by Jan Ors and Kyle Katarn, with the former usually piloting the ship, when Katarn's mercenary missions required him to fight against the Imperial Remnant on foot. They found this ship when their Moldy Crow crash-landed on Rusan, when the plot guided them to this opportune vehicle. During one mission, Jan Ors was kidnapped, and in Katarn's search for her, Jedi Master Skywalker promised he would look over this ship. When the kidnapper became one with the Force, the pair returned to their ship and continued to use the Ravenclaw on their mercenary exploits. That's it for its history, and the only behind-the-scenes fact is that a fellow member of Luke's Jedi Praxium, Jaden Kor, was once co-pilot of this ship when Kor and Katarn hunted down Sith cultists known as the Disciples of Ragnos. And this ship made its first appearance in Jedi Knight II, but also appeared in Jedi Academy. So that's it for the mysterious custom ship, the Ravenclaw. If you want to connect with us, help support this channel, or get your own copies of the reference material used to make this video, be sure to check out the links in the description. Special shout out to our supporters over on Patreon, but most important of all, remember, open yourself up to the plot, and it will guide you to ample rewards. And the Force will be with you. Always.